Surrattsville's player and coach.
Coach, you made some threes late, but before that, I mean, shooting was woeful. I had you for 17 turnovers in the game. Do you feel like in the end that that was what got you today?
No.
What do you feel about?
First of all, let me say this. I think these guys play their hearts out. That's a part of the game. Take shots, you miss shots. You make an errant pass, you make a good pass. That's a part of the game. I don't think that was the sole reason, the reason why we lost. I mean, we had wide open looks. We missed. Understand this, I mean, I look at the game of basketball as you got to put the ball in the basket. But there were times where, you know, I thought we could rebound the ball better. There were times where I thought, you know, we could have made an extra pass, put us in a better position to make an easier shot. I mean, it's easy to say if you, I mean, both teams missed quite a few shots.
Right.
But that's easy. That's pretty much the easiest way to put it. You know what I mean? But ultimately, you miss a shot because you may not put your teammate in a good position to make a better shot. You kind of see what I'm saying?
Coach, Lake Clifton is kind of known year in, year out as having one of the best defenses in the state of Maryland. Was their defense above average? Was it, I know you played a tough
we've
league.
Seen that, but we've seen that defense all year. That was the I don't take nothing away from Lake Clifton. I respect all opponents. But, I mean, we've played teams tough in Lake Clifton. I don't take anything away from our coach, Herm, Terry. I think he's got to play a pretty good game. I would say they were disciplined and running their stuff and getting to the free throw line. But I mean, for them to say that they had a great defense, I mean, we held them 14 points at halftime. I think our defense was good too.
But there was a stretch, Coach, in that third quarter where they pressured you guys and you had some couple of turnovers that kind of changed momentum a little bit. Talk about that.
Third quarter? Yeah. There were a couple few times we those times we miscommunicated on a couple of our passes. That's being on the same page. And like I said, going back to what I said before, that Clifton was disciplined and making a good pass, a good, sharp, crisp pass, where we kind of, you know, we were there. And I had to talk with them, my guy in the practice. I said, you know, you're on the stage, you're playing on a different floor. That same pass you normally make during the regular season might not be there.
Mm-hmm.
So you got to understand, you got to put a bit of zip in the pass, and you got to be able to get in position to go get the pass.
Malik, what were you remember about this run? He hasn't been here since like 07-08. What will you remember about this team and this run you got in this season you guys had this year?
We got here. A lot of people didn't get here to get this experience like we did. I love my teammates. Love them all.
I believe you provided a nice spark off the bench when you came in there. What was your mindset coming into the game when the coach said you? How were you able to make an impact so quickly?
Robert, you guys had a really good offense all year. You guys had, there's a couple games you put up over 100 points this year. And then what got going there late when you guys made that comeback? Was it just, was it hard shooting on these baskets in a bigger gym?
Yeah, it was a different feel shooting. I think I had a couple wide open shots. I just rushed it a little bit. They was trying to face guard. Coach was going to tell me they was going to try to face guard me and stop me from shooting, which they came out of the gate and was doing. But I think our younger guys stepped up and they made big plays during the stretch.
Coach Newman, just talk about the experience with these young men when I was working for the Gazette. You was coaching the girls team and you got them to the States. I mean, just talk about the experiences. I mean, any difference or?
I mean, going forward, I mean, when we won the regional championship, and I told these guys, our goal ultimately in the beginning of the year, back in, what?
July?
June? I don't know. I mean, during that long summer, when we won our summer league over in Virginia, I knew we had a team. I knew we were going to get here. And they knew that. A lot of people didn't have us on the radar. Everybody in our league, pressure was high. Everybody knows about the Douglas is going to park and all those good teams. But at the same time, I mean, we compete, you know, day in and day out with those guys. And they'll tell you, you know, we're a scrappy, feisty, young team. young team that that just was dedicated from the off season up to this point, and they knew what our goal was going into this year. I knew we had the experience, you know, with the addition of Bernard Lane. He didn't have a good game today, but he helped us throughout the entire season. He carried us a lot of times. He had a good game this day, but hey, look, you know, like Malik said, you know, it's a team game, and our bench guys stepped up when Nathaniel fouled out and when Gregory the poor fouled out. The bench came in to ride a spark. We cut the lead, we got back into it. I take my hats off to these guys because they did something that a lot of people did not expect us to do. Nobody had no idea what Surrattsville High School was going to do this year. And here we are, the show will prove it. We have a chance to prove it. We came short, but at the same time, like I said, I'm going to tell you right now, I'm pretty sure you guys didn't have a clue who we were in the beginning of the season. Watch the Post. I look at the Washington Post every day, and I'm like, wow, you know, even though we're losing, but at the same time, if you watch us play, you see, they night in, night out, we compete every single night with those teams, with Largo, with Glen Park, all of them, night in, night out. And they tell me, all right, say, you know, look, I take my hats off to the guys that did a wonderful job, had a great year.
Daniel, what did you guys do defensively to really work in the first half there, holding the team like that to 14 points?
I honestly could say, I mean, we just came out aggressive. We did the same thing in the second half, but like Coach said, we was just missing shots, and they was just making shots. So I mean, I honestly think we didn't do anything different. I think we played physical, hard basketball, all 4 quarters.
Thanks, guys.
Congratulations. Thanks.